All right, so this is the video to go over the Create Performance Task Rubric Quiz. All right, so what we want to do is we want to make sure as we go through this that we are going back and checking out the rubric as we go. All right, so the first three questions relate to row one. All right, so that means we want to make sure that we are looking at row one. We want to make sure that the scoring criteria are met. Right, the written response scoring criteria are met, but then we also pay attention to the decision rules. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look. All right, so for number one, it says the purpose of this program is to allow the user to create a picture of an ice cream cone with the number of cones of their choosing. All right, the video shows a user click on the canvas at 5200, then the user shows a user clicking at 200, 100, and the program asks the user to enter the number of scoops they would like. All right, so first thing says, the video demonstrates the running of the program, including input, program functionality, and output, right? So if you viewed the video, you would see that it does, in fact, show the program running, right? So it shows the function. It shows input, right? So user clicking. It shows output, what appears on the screen. All right, but now, does the written response describe the overall purpose of the program? Well, the purpose of the program is to allow the user to create a picture of an ice cream cone. Okay, so yes, it does. Does it describe what functionality of the program is demonstrated in the video, right? So it describes the functionality, right? User clicking on the canvas, right? Ask the program to enter, ask the user to enter the number of scoops, right? Does it describe the input and the output of the program? Well, it does not describe the output, right? It says the video shows the user clicking, yes. Then it shows the user clicking again. So actually, this is describing input as well, right? And the program asks the user to enter the number of scoops they would like. This is more input, right? Program input. It does not actually describe the output. So this response earns the point for row one. That is false. All right, next. The purpose is to write a program. Okay, so now we need to make sure we think about this, okay? Does the written response describe the overall purpose of the program? Okay, so the purpose of the program, the purpose is to write a program. Now, okay, we're talking about the purpose of the program. So what does the program accomplish, right? So if we look back at number one, it says the purpose of this program is to allow. So what does the program do, right? The purpose is to write a program. That is not the purpose of the program. Okay, that might be the user's purpose, right? But not the purpose of the program, not why does the program exist, all right? So we would say that this response earns a point for row one. That is false, right? But now let's see about the other aspects. The video shows the user clicking on the far left of the canvas and then a label displaying telling the user to click closer to the center. They then try the far right of the canvas and a label is still displayed telling the user to click closer to the center. Next, the user clicks near the center of the canvas and the user is prompted to enter the number of scoops. Then a picture of an ice cream cone with that number of scoops is drawn in the canvas. So now we're talking about the output, right? So in two, the writer describes the input. So the user clicking, right? And then entering the number of scoops, then the output. Right, what actually shows on the screen after the input has occurred. But because they did not describe the purpose of the program, this user does not earn row one. All right, next. The purpose of the program is to ask the user how many ice cream cones they want and create a picture of that number of cones. All right, so now has the student describe the overall purpose of the program? Okay, yes. All right, next. The video showed a user clicking on the outer parts of the canvas, which is true, and getting a message to click in the center. Then they click near the middle of the canvas, and then the user entered the number two, right? The input is the coordinates of the user clicks and the number of the user enters, and the output is an ice cream cone with two scoops drawn on the canvas. So they talked about what the video shows. They talked about what the input is, and then they talk about what the output is. So let's go back to here, okay? Does the video demonstrate input, program functionality, output? Yes, right? We already discussed that, but now, did the user describe the overall purpose? Yes. Did they describe what functionality of the program is demonstrated in the video? Yes. Do they describe the input and the output of the program? demonstrated in the video? Yes. Okay, now we always want to go over here to decision rules. Do not award a point if the video does not show a demonstration of the program running. Okay, well, it did. And so this would be true. Number three would be true. Okay, so now we're done with row one. All right, so let's move on. Questions four and five are getting at rows two and three. All right, so let's take a look at this. Okay, colors equals pink, yellow, purple. Label equals colors right here. Print, click on the canvas, app.count equals zero. All right, the user says, or the student says, the name of the list is colors. And the values in the list are used to represent colors used in the program. The list is displayed when the program first runs, and then these colors appear as colors of the scoops when the ice cream cone is drawn on the canvas. All right, so now we want to think, okay, what is rows two and three? All right, so this response earns the point for row two, true or false. This response earns the point for row three, true or false. All right, so let's take a look at row two. I apologize. The written response includes two program code segments. All right, are there two program code segments? Yes, there's one and then there's two. Okay, so there are two. Now, okay, one that shows how the data has been stored in this list, right? Or other collection type, right? So like a group or something, but in this case, we are using a list. One that shows the data in this same list being used as part of fulfilling the program's purpose. All right, so let's look. We've got the first list showing data stored in the list, yes. And then this one, do I see any reference to the colors list in this? Well, we are displaying the colors list, right? But we're not actually using the colors list as a part of the program's purpose. And so for that reason, we would say this response earns a point for row two, false, right? Because it does not show a program code segment that uses, that shows the data in the same list being used as fulfilling part of the program's purpose. All right, but then identifies the name of the variable representing the list being used? Well, yes, it did, right? It says that the name of the list is colors, okay? And then describes what the data contained in this list is representing in the program. And yes, it does accomplish that as well, okay? So that's row two. All right, but what about row three, okay? All right, row three, it says the written response includes a program code segment that shows a list being used to manage complexity in the program and then explains how the named selected list manages complexity in the program by explaining why the program code segment could not be written or how it would be written differently without using this list. All right, so this list is displayed when the program runs, and then these colors appear as the colors of the scoops when the ice cream cone is drawn on the canvas. Okay, nothing about explaining how the name list manages complexity or how the program could not be written or how it would be written differently, right? So that is not satisfied, and so the student would not earn the point for row three. All right. All right, and then we want to make sure we look at this if we are still unsure of whether or not a point should be earned or not. All right, let's go ahead and move along to questions six and seven. So still looking at rows two and three. All right, so do they have two program code segments? Okay, yes and yes. Okay, so now row two. Okay, two program code segments, yes. One that shows how data has been stored, okay. Yes, right, colors equals, and then one showing how this same list is being used to fulfill the program's purpose. So now we see a for loop, right, and here colors X is being used. So that means first time through the loop, we're using pink, then yellow, then purple, and so we are using that, okay? Now, it also must identify the name of the variable and describe what is being used. All right, so the name of the list is colors, and the values represent the colors that will be used to fill the scoops. All right, so it looks like row two has been satisfied. So this response earns the point for row two, true, all right? But now, okay, we want to make sure we look over here, right? Requirements for program code segments. The written response must include two clearly distinguishable program code segments, which there are. If the written response includes more than two code segments, well, it didn't, so that's not applicable here. Do not award a point if the use of a list is trivial and does not assist in fulfilling the program's purpose. Is this the use of this list trivial? No, because I can use a for loop, right? And if we wanted to add elements to the list, I would not have to change this at all. So if I had 10 colors, this would still work, right? And so that's important. It's not trivial. It's not like a single variable. All right. So now let's move on to row three. All right. Includes a program code segment that shows a list being used to manage complexity of the program and explains how the list manages complexity. All right. So we're looking at this V here. All right. This list manages complexity of the program by allowing the for loop to iterate the number of scoops that the user has selected. Without the for loop, we would need a few if and elif conditionals to determine the number of colors to use for the drawing and appropriately fill the circles with color. All right. And so would this earn the point for row three? And the answer is true. Yes, it should earn the point for row three because all this is satisfied. But now we also want to go over here. Do not award a point if any of the following is true. Let's make sure. The code segments containing the list are not separately included in the written response section, which they are. The written response does not name the selected list, which it did. The use of the list is irrelevant or not used in the program. That is not true. The explanation does not apply to the selected list. That's not true. The explanation of how the list manages complexity is implausible, inaccurate, or inconsistent with the program. Not true. The solution without the list is implausible, inaccurate, or inconsistent with the program. Not true. The use of the list does not result in a program that is easier to develop, meaning alternatives presented are equally complex or potentially easier. And then the use of the list does not result in a program that is easier to maintain. Well, I already explained that it is easier to maintain because if I added colors and added scoops, then I could keep this the same. And so it makes it a little bit easier. All right. All right. So let's go on to question 8 and 9, still getting at rows 2 and 3. So do we have two separate code segments? Yes. Does one of them show the colors list? Yes. Does one of them talk about how the colors list is being used in the purpose of the program? It doesn't look like it does, right? So we would say false for row 2 on this one, okay? But now let's look at number 9, okay? The name of the list is colors, yes. The values represent colors, yes. So that would be part of row 2. But now row 3, okay? This list manages the complexity of the program by allowing the for loop to iterate the number of scoops that the user has selected. Without the for loop, the program would need a few if and elif conditionals to determine the number of colors for drawing and appropriately fill the circles with colors. All right. And so we see here that this would earn the point for row 3. Why? Because now we are talking about how this list is going to manage the complexity of the program. All right. And so we want to make sure, you know, that we explain how the selected list manages complexity. Yes. All right. And so that would earn the point for row 3. All right. So next we will move on to questions 10 through 18 in a separate video.